What is ProGuard? ProGuard is an open source tool that we can use to shrink, optimize, obfuscate our Java bytecode. It shrinks APK size by removing the unused code and obfuscate the remaining code to prevent from reverse engineering. So ProGuard first detect all of your unused code from your APK and it will simply remove that code. By doing this thing, it will automatically decrease your APK size, and once your APK size decreases, automatically performance wise it will behave better. So let's understand this thing with a very simple scenario. Suppose you are using one library into your project that contains 10 different features, but you are interested only one feature. Now what will happen with the 9 different features that your library contains? Well, if you are not using ProGuard and generating your APK, this 9 feature is included into your APK and ultimately it will increase your APK size. Now what will happen if you are using ProGuard? On that case, it will simply eliminate those 9 features from your APK. By doing this, automatically your APK size will be decreased and performance wise it will behave better than the previous APK. So this is the use case of ProGuard. Next, it enhances your security. So automatically it will obfuscate all of your class name, function name, attributes name into some gibberish so that no one can access or try to understand your code very easily. If your source code contains one function naming get images, now after obfuscation, this get images function name will be converted into let's say ABC. Even though you have written your own code base, but after obfuscation, you are not able to understand. So this is very important thing, because if somehow someone access your code base, still they have to decode all of the obfuscation to get the original code. So this is the benefit of using ProGuard. So always use ProGuard in your project. So let's see how we can use ProGuard in our Android project. But before that, in Android, we are using R8. Now, R8 is a better version of ProGuard. Performance-wise, it will behave better than ProGuard, and also it will reduce the build time. So let's see how we can enable it in our project and see how obfuscation looks like. So for that, you will need a project. So simply create a new project for yourself. I have created that project for myself. Now it's time to begin with it. So here, just change your mode from Android to project. Open up your build.gradle.kts of module app level. In your Android closer, we have build type, and in this build type, we have release. So mostly we'll use ProGuard in our release build, because release build is open source and everyone can download it and see it very easily. So that's why always apply ProGuard in your release version. Cool. So here you can see isMinify enabled. isMinify enabled is the key that is used to determine whether ProGuard is enabled in your project or not. So initially it is false. So I'm gonna use true. By using true, automatically it will enable ProGuard for us. Next, we have here ProGuard files. Now this is the file that contains set of rules for optimization. This is mostly used to optimize Android applications. So all of the rules, the logic, how obfuscation will be happen under the hood is written over here. Next, we have ProGuard rules.pro. This is the file, and in this file we'll write something in this video. Just wait for it. Alright, so in our build.gradle KTS, I'm enabling my ProGuard. And this thing is actually used to handle the ProGuard things. Next, we have here is shrink resources. So once you enable this minify enable to true, it will enable the ProGuard for your source code that is present in your Java folder over here. If you want to shrink your resources to that present in this directory, on that case, you can use is shrink resources to true. Now what it will do, let's say in our values string.xml, I have one more string naming something, and its value is something, but I'm not using it. So if you are using is shrink resources true, it will automatically remove this thing after the obfuscation. So this is a use case of is shrink resources. All right, so now it's time to play with ProGuard. So for that, first I'm going to create a package, and the package name is fake. And in this fake, I'm going to create a class. To be more specific, it's a data class that contain name as a member variable. Let's use this thing in our main activity. import it, name is my name, which is Himansu. In place of Android, I'm using my fake name. Okay, sync your project so that it will enable ProGuard. Okay, so if you want to see the obfuscation, for that, change the build variant from debug, which is default one, to release, and sync your project. After that, go on the top. In the build, we have here clean project. So simply clean your project and rebuild it. Because we have been enabled, is Binify enabled true, is sync resources true, it will take little more time to perform all of those operations. Okay, so here we have a build folder. Open up this build folder. In the outputs, we have mapping that contains a file naming mapping.txt. Now, this is the file that is used to map your class name to obfuscated name. So here you can see this is our fake data class. Now it will be renamed into no.a. So in the real code base, after obfuscation, you are not able to understand what is the meaning of this. So this is how you can perform obfuscation. Okay, so let's see how we can prevent this fake from obfuscation. Sometimes you have to prevent a few classes from obfuscation. So let's see how we can do it. So for that, go to your fake data class, and on the top you can use annotation keep. Now again, clean your project and rebuild it. Okay, open up your build, outputs, mapping, mapping.txt, and search for fake.kt. And this time you can see this is our actual data class name, and this time it won't obfuscate it because we are preventing this thing by using this keep annotation. So by using this keep annotation, you can prevent it. Remove this keep annotation. Let's do the same thing with our ProGuard.profile, which present over here. So let's say I want to prevent the class fake from obfuscation. So for that, you can use dash keep class and mention the class name, which is fake. Okay, again, just clean your project and rebuild it. Go to the top, look out for the build, output, mapping, mapping.txt. Just search for fake.kt. Here you can see it is not obfuscated. Cool. Now let's do one more thing. So I'm going to create an interface in a package, and the package name is inter. We have a interface, and the interface name is fake interface. That contain one function in it, get custom message. Return type of this function is string. Now we have two different classes that actually implemented this interface. So for that, I am gonna create a package which is IMPL. We have here our first IMPL class which implements fake interface. Similarly, we have one more class naming second IMPL. It uses fake interface and provide its implementation. We have here second IMPL. Cool. So now it's time to use it. Go to your main activity, and on the top, I'm going to create a private while first IMPL with the help of first IMPL. Next, we have private while second IMPL and create an object of second IMPL. It's time to use it. So here, I'm using plus function, first implementation dot get custom message. Again, I'm using plus function. This time I'm using second implementation dot get custom message. Alright, so just clean the project and rebuild it. Open up the build folder, outputs, mapping, mapping.txt. Let's search for our first IMPL. So see, first IMPL will become W and our second IMPL will become X. Cool. So if you check all the other things regarding the first implementation, so first implementation will become W. Now I want to prevent every class from obfuscation that have been implemented fake interface. So how can you do it? Well, for that, go to your ProGuard-rules.pro. And here add keep class, I mean all class that have implements our interface, and the interface name is fake interface. Okay, so just clean your project and rebuild it. Alright, so open up your build outputs mapping.txt and try to search first IMPL. See, this time it will use the same name, first implementation. Similarly, if you are searching for second implementation, so we have four places. So let's see, here you can see second implementation is used as it is, second implementation. Cool. So now it's time to see how we can protect our package that contains model classes from obfuscation. So for that, let me create few classes within the model package. So in this model package, this scenario will be happen when you want to get some information from backend. On that case, you have to create few model classes that will match your JSON, and you will simply use JSON converter factory to convert your JSON into these model classes. So in this case, this model will be protected from obfuscation, otherwise your application sometimes will crash. So let's see how we can prevent it. So for that, let's create two data class, and the data class name is model first class. Okay, so in this I'm simply passing naming string. We have one more class, and this time I'm gonna name it model second class. Wall name, we have a string over here. Now it's time to use it. So go to your main activity, private wall first, and the class name is model first class, and in place of name just type some gibberish. Similarly, private wall second, model second class, and in place of name I'm typing some gibberish. It's time to use the first and second. So here I'm using plus first plus second. Alright, so now I want to protect these two classes from obfuscation. So let's see how we can do it. For that, open up your ProGuard rules.pro. Use here keep class. Mention your package name, which is core Himanshu ProGuard model dot. Use here two asterisks. Open a pair of parentheses. Again use asterisk and semicolon. So just clean your project and rebuild it to see whether it is obfuscated or not. Okay, open up your build output mapping.txt and try to search model first class. Okay, so we are not able to find it, so find it like this way, model first class KT. Here you can see model first class is not obfuscated, it has the same name. Similarly, we have model second class. So let's see how we can prevent some public function that present within a class. So suppose in our main activity, I'm having a public function, and the function name is, let's say, my custom function. So it has some gibberish variable. Cool. And I'm using this function over here, my custom function, and I want to prevent it from obfuscation, only the public function that present within the main activity. So how can you do it? Well, for that, open up your ProGuard-rule.pro. Use here keep class, use your main activity, and open a pair of parentheses. Use here public, all public. So for all, you should use here asterisk. And lastly, a semicolon. So what it will do, it will simply prevent all of the member function that present into your main activity, which is public, from obfuscation. So just clean your project and rebuild it. All right, so if you want to see the function name, my custom function, in your mapping.txt, you can find it. It's very easy, it's not a big deal. All right, so now it's time to execute this application in our emulator. So for that, we have to change our build variant from release to debug. It's a very simple project. Just execute it, it will work. Okay, so this is the very basic project. That's all for this video. I hope you enjoyed a lot. It's a very important video, because if you are not using ProGuard and publish your application into Play Store, it will be very risky. So don't do that. So yeah, that's it for this video. If you like this video, subscribe my channel and also write your comments if you found any problems or if you like this video. We'll meet in our next video where we will discuss something new about Android. Till that, goodbye.